Championship of the Italian Open. And there she is, playing her 22nd and last year, Martina Navratilova. And today, Martina takes on Conchita Martinez, the number one seed in our championship match. Hi, everybody. I'm Steve Mayer, along with 1971 Italian Open champion Virginia Wade. And Virginia, this is a wonderful event.
Oh, it's one of the best tournaments of the year, and you get a sunny day like this, the perfect conditions, the atmosphere is always absolutely buzzing. And with Martina playing, she's been so popular here, and you know that when she's got as far as the final, she's in good form.
Virginia, let's take a look at the draw, where you see in the quarterfinals, Adriana Zerazzanetti made some headlines.
Yeah, it's so great when a young Italian does well here in Rome. The crowd goes berserk. And she beat Anke Huber, and then she beat Brenda Schultz, and then she played Hapsidova, who she lost to, who eliminated Mary Pierce. So pretty solid draw. Spalia, Loredan, the arena, had beaten Sabatini early on in the tournament.
And Martina was able to beat Spalia in the semifinal 6-2, 6-3. Martina losing just one set all week. She lost back in the round of 16 to Ines Garaciategui,
who she lost to earlier this year.
So Martina in fine form to take on Conchita Martinez, who has also lost just one set this week. That came in the round of 16 to Patricia Tarabini.
But her other matches, very much routine, very easygoing. She won the tournament here last year. She is a wonderful clay court player.
It'll be interesting throughout the day to see how Conchita Martinez can handle the pressure. Martina Navratilova is such a crowd favorite.
Which she is, and also her game is very well suited to beat or to give trouble to Conchita. Although on these slow courts, Martina will have to be an awfully good form to convert that into a win.
You can hear the crowd there behind Martina as she takes on Conchita Martinez in the championship match.
The way to not win in tennis is to think too much about your opponent. Because in tennis, you don't just play the opponent. You've got to play the ball. It's how you play the ball that determines whether your shot is in or out. Whether the point is won or lost. Play the ball better than your opponent, and you'll play winning tennis. Now, you can play the ball and win with this double offer from Tennis Magazine. You'll receive a free half-hour video by Tennis Magazine instruction editor Vic Braden, plus a full year, 12 issues of Tennis Magazine. Call this number now and change the way you play tennis. What a combination. The How to Play Winning Tennis with Vic Braden video, plus the magazine that brings more instruction to more tennis players than any other.
Call 800-228-1300 for a full year of Tennis Magazine, plus this free video, just $16.77. Call 800-228-1300 now.
Back to 4-0 Italico, the championship of the Italian Open, the number one seed, Conchita Martinez, against the number two seed, Martina Navratilova. A nice sized crowd looking on as Conchita Martinez comes in as the number three player in the world.
She's an immensely talented player. Sometimes she gets just a little sluggish on the court. But this year her ranking has gone up to third in the world, and she's been in the quarterfinals or better in all six events she's played, only winning one tournament at Hilton Head. She didn't manage to defend her title in Houston this year.
And there's Martina Navratilova, still ranked as the number four player in the world.
37, but it's incidental, her age. Martina's still as fast and as fit as she's ever been, and has played with tremendous enthusiasm this year. She seems to me to have had more pleasure playing than ever before. Hasn't done very well on clay, had three first round losses, which was a first for her, but now has got herself geared up for this surface.
So we're ready for the championship of the Italian Open. Martinez to serve first.
For sure, Martina will start off being as aggressive as she possibly can. If she could connect with balls as deep and accurate as that early on, then she might just not give Conchita a chance to get in the match.
That one's long, and quickly it's love 30.
I'm sure Conchita is a little bit nervous. You know, it's a lot of responsibility owning the title of this tournament.
Martinez had some run en route to the championship here, defeating Martina Navratilova, Mary Jo Fernandez, and Gabriella Sabatini to win the championship. Triple break point.
A good first serve from Conchita, but if you think about the time in the tournament at which they play each other, I would say that Martina was much more vulnerable in the early rounds than in the final. By the time you've developed your confidence by winning a bunch of matches and developed the sort of rhythm that is required of the surface, you're going to be a better player.
Backhand sells long, so it's 30-40.
And each match that Martina has played this week has really got a little bit better than that one shaky set against Ines Garrochategui. But, you know, considering she lost to her, it was a good win in three sets.
So Martinez has fought back nicely here in the first game. We're at deuce.
A couple of sloppy returns from Martina. They've rattled over there.
Again, another break point opportunity coming for Navratilova.
Conchita Martinez has so much variety at her hand. She can slice the backhand and put extreme topspin on. And it's going to be interesting to see which tactic she uses against Martina.
Beautiful forehand down the line, and Navratilova wins the first game.
I can.
You can make it if you try.
You can either quit and give up and cry and say,
I can't do that.
Or you can keep trying to do it and keep trying to do it.
If you put your mind to it, you can achieve anything.
You can make it if you try.
If someone tells you you can't, tell them I can. Stay in school. It's your best move.
The power. The punishment. The pain. The ultimate sports spectacular. Now you can relive the excitement on home video with top-ranked grade.
to order Top Rank's greatest knockouts. This video makes the perfect gift. Sorry, no CODs. For faster delivery, please have your credit card ready and call 1-800-542-9100. That's 1-800-542-9100.
Playing in her 22nd year, her last year on the singles tour, Martina Navratilova to serve for the first time today.
Supportive of Martina here. Exactly the right return, but those soft hands picked it up, that little touch shot. Well, she's getting away with serving and volleying. I always feel on clay that if you, this is your favorite tactic to serve and volley like it is for Martina, you should maybe do it about 50 or 60% of the time, but not all the time. Oh, that's brilliant. And that's already seems to maybe be what she's trying to do. She chose not to come in that time. Knows that right here she's got Conchita in problems, so she slips into the net. Executes just a magnificent touch volley.
Beautiful angle, and it's 40 love. Double fall. First double fault of the afternoon. Now we're at 40-15. On her farewell tour, Martina Navratilova has decided to play some clay court events. Only played one last year, and that one's an ace. So Navratilova holds serve, and quickly she's ahead 2-love. There's a look at the seeds. The number one and number two seeds have made it through to the finals. The real shocker came with the Sabatini loss in the first round.
And Anke Huber not in form this year. Mary Pierce up and down. Amanda Kutsa did well here in the last couple of years, so that was a surprise. The returns from both players have not quite found their groove yet. Martina would dearly love to win this tournament. Believe it or not, she's never won the Italian Championships, ever. Must be one of the few records to get past her grasp.
First year she played this tournament was back in 1974. And what a return for Martina Navratilova right there. Played this tournament in 1974, in fact made the final that year, losing to Chris Everett. She has made the finals here before, but with shots like this one, hoping that she can go all the way to her first ever championship in Italy.
No!
Forehand sails wide, and it's 15-30. Early on, it looks like Martinez is just not comfortable on the court.
It does look like that. She's a very consistent performer, but she does show quite a lot of nervous tension in matches.
Just wide. But Martina certainly on the aggressive, certainly going for her shots early on.
Well, that's her game, and that's the only way that she's really going to beat these other players. Trouble is, as more time goes by and the balls get used, they get a little slower. You have to assert yourself at the beginning when the balls are pretty fast. The danger comes around 4-all, that time when they're just about to change the balls. So good.
Martina closes brilliantly. And it's 30-40 and her fifth break point in the first two games.
What a joy it is to watch Martina when she's as sharp as this. Every shot she hits has a purpose.
No!
Martina breaks serve again so quickly. She goes ahead over Conchita Martinez, 3-love.
Are you tired of the high cost and inconvenience of having your rackets restrung? Save money by stringing your own racket in as little as 30 minutes. The ClipperMate can be paid for in as few as 6 restringings. This professional stringing machine is made in the USA and comes completely assembled with stringing tools, easy to follow instructions, free synthetic gut, and a grip for your racket handle. All this and a full 10-year guarantee. Why waste time and money when you can string your own rackets with professional results? For a free brochure on America's best-selling racket stringer or to order, call 1-800-522-5547.
To give my home a nice atmosphere, I've tried French Provincial, Danish Modern, English Country, and Spanish Colonial. Little did I know that for nice atmosphere, all I really needed was American Standard, a reliable American Standard air conditioning system. It's one design that will last. I wish I'd known that back during my Spanish Colonial period.
American Standard air conditioning, built to a higher standard.
Make your money work harder than ever. Call now for your free Wall Street Journal guide to understanding money and investing. It focuses on financial markets so you can make informed choices. Call now to get your guide free when you subscribe to the Wall Street Journal, where you'll find information you need to get ahead. Get 10 weeks of the journal for just $36 and the guide to understanding money and investing free with your paid subscription. Call toll-free 800-322-5800. That's 800-322-5800.
Martina Navratilova has come out playing well, and she now leads 3-love, having broke the serve of Conchita Martinez twice in the first three games. But Martinez comes up with a backhand winner. She needs shots like that to get herself into the match.
Well, she's returned okay, but that return, although it was straight onto Martinez's racket, gave her an awkward volley. She couldn't get any angle off the volley. Martina, I've always felt volley's better when the ball is actually at full stretch. Well, maybe not the right choice of shot for her going for a big topspin backhand, and it looked to me as if Martina actually hesitated deciding which shot. It's her bread and butter to make a slice approach shot, and that could have been an opportunity. So a little problem here, love 30.
A little lazy on the volley for Martina.
Yeah, I mean, this shot here is not too bad. And where was she? She just went to sleep, I think.
So it's love 40, triple break point for Conchita Martinez. Beautiful backhand volley for Navratilova.
She needed that point. It's not good to let a game slip away as fast as that game was going.
Her first game of the match, and now she trails Martina Navratilova 3-1. We mentioned last year Martinez won this Italian Open. Mentioned that this was the only clay court event that Martina Navratilova played. Remember last year, of course, Martina out with an ankle injury, suffered the injury while playing basketball, and this was her first tournament back.
Martina was actually brought up on European red clay in Prague. Says she likes playing on it, but doesn't play enough to really feel totally comfortable. Just a slight misjudgment of hers there.
One of the first times we've seen Martinez come to net. Big shot by Navratilova, and it's 15-all. This, of course, the surface that Conchita Martinez is most comfortable playing, and it's the surface in which she's had the most success. It's shut.
Together by Conchita, showing her game at its very best, really driving her opponent out of position and then making her chase down the balls. Extreme angle she produces on her shots. A little impetuous there from Martina. Well, Conchita, of course, this is her best surface because really of the way she hits the ball with the heavy topspin on the forehand and the variety on the backhand. She got to the semi-final of Wimbledon last year and played very well on the grass. Good shot.
Beautiful shot again. The top from Conchita Martinez. Martina Vrakalova is still off her break.
Week is not recommended for dabblers or dilettantes. It's the Sports Insider publication. There is no such thing as a friendly game to our readers. Tennis Week is full of interviews with the stars, action photos, and tournament draws. Information you simply can't get anywhere else. We're read first because we come out first. Tennis Week. Serious reading about serious tennis.
What time is it? Time for NBA action. A high flying hoop show that's on top of the game. You get it all.
Here's Isaiah.
The hottest players and teams. Your favorite personality. And the greatest plays of the week. All this and more coming your way in NBA action.
NBA action every week exclusively on Sports Channel.
Premiering Saturday, May 21st on AMC, John Wayne and Kirk Douglas in the story of two men at war with the enemy. And at war with themselves.
Get on your feet or take your troubles elsewhere. I got a ship to run.
Henry Fonda co-stars in Otto Preminger's World War II epic, In Harm's Way. Premiering Saturday, May 21st at 8 p.m. Central on AMC.
Welcome back. Martina Navratilova to serve, leading 3-2 here in the first set, the championship of the Italian Open. Will take home $150,000, while the runner-up takes home $60,000.
Big disparity. Usually the finalist takes half of the winner's check.
No!
Well, she got away with that, Martina, but it's going to be difficult for her to contend with those returns at her feet. So much more pressure on her first serve. If she can really come up with some big first serves, it's going to help her. But knowing that she has to make better first serve, she's going to miss a few too.
We mentioned and saw the prize money. Is there a different state of mind when a player is playing for a big difference like we saw here in this match?
Oh, I think that's a very good question, but I think, in fact, the player's much more concerned with the importance of the tournament.
No!
Good serve and volley. You can't tell me that these two players are actually thinking about the number of zeros on the end of the dollar amount they're going to get. They're thinking about the title. If you can win the Italian championships, it's really a huge feather in your cap.
Go!
Virginia Wade has a feather in her cap after winning this tournament in 1971.
Oh, this tournament was, for me, something I really wanted to win. It was difficult for me being on slow play.
Tough shot for Conchita Martinez to handle. The ball sort of just stops, and we'll watch it once again.
Martina, a little bit lazy getting over to that, puts on so much underspin, gives Conchita a chance to get back into position, but that really took that spin. 40-30. Another chance that was missed by Martina. You know, normally this is a good time to hit behind the opponent with the volley. But Conchita hadn't really moved over to the open space, was very ready for that, and had sailed it over Martina's head before Martina really caught on what was going on.
We're at deuce. Wide open court. And it'll be advantage Martinez.
Conchita is beginning to realize that she has to just stay in the points a little bit longer. Just got them out. Break points.
Second break point for Conchita Martinez. And she will convert.
I tell you, that was a fantastic volley of Martina. She's really not in a very good position here. Makes a tremendous lunge and it executes just a gorgeous volley. As I said, her volleying is really at its best when she's at full reach. Look, let's see another one.
Martinez was able to hit it to the open court. Martina Navratilova able to get there, but the backhand into the net. And another break point here for Conchita Martinez. For the third time this game.
It was really a point that Conchita Martinez should have won. Martina hit a few sort of short forehands. When she gets forced to stay back, her forehand gets a little bit, not exactly shaky, but just not quite convincing enough.
Whether Martina Navratilova has weathered this storm. Martina holds serve. She now leads 4-2.
The White Sox and Rangers. It's live Sunday at 2, and it's only on Sports Channel. The power. The punishment. The pain. The ultimate sports spectacular. Now you can relive the excitement on home video with top-ranked greatest knockouts. Volumes 1 and 2, together on one full-length cassette. Legends like Hagler, Whale, Duran, 22 knockouts that changed boxing history.
order Top Rank's greatest knockout. This video makes the perfect gift. Sorry, no CODs. For faster delivery, please have your credit card ready and call 1-800-542-9100. That's 1-800-542-9100.
Welcome back.
Yeah, Martina, just not going to be able to get away with that. Gets the chance to do what she wants with it. You saw how high the drop volley was over the net. She just didn't manage to bring it down low and make it stop dead. It wasn't a, it's not a bad play against Conchita though. You see again that backhand of hers, it's a bread and butter, the slice approach shot, but she only made it as far as the service line.
Conchita Martinez's game picking up, 30 love. She has won 13 career titles. 8 of those have been on clay, where she's known as one of the world's top performers.
Two, four down in this first set. 30 love.
Virginia, we talked about Conchita Martinez. She has made the quarters of the French the last 5 years, but she's such an underrated performer. She's the number three player in the entire world.
I know. I have a lot of respect for her game. It's just that sometimes you'll see her in a match and she's really looks not terribly motivated. In fact, her Spanish people who've been brought up with her will all say she's got tremendous talent, more probably than Arantxa, but doesn't work as hard.
That one just misses, and it's 40-15. She is number three in the world, and as you mentioned, number two in Spain behind Arantxa Sánchez-Vicario. But certainly a threat to perhaps go very, very far in the upcoming French Open.
She's got to be one of the contenders. A lot will depend on the way the draw comes out.
Maybe. What do you think of Martina Navratilova's chances in the French Open?
Well, again, I think that if she can get through her early rounds and build confidence as she has in this tournament, I think she has a very good chance of doing well. Whether she can actually win is another question. I mean, I wouldn't put my money on her getting further than the semis, basically.
To go to the break, here's another Nagelson know-how with Betsy Nagelson.
Welcome to the beautiful Ritz-Carlton at Kapalua on the island of Maui. We all go through slumps in our games, some worse than others. But the way to get back on track is to concentrate on playing percentage tennis. Play shots you're capable of, and cut down on the unforced errors. First of all, aim cross court. When you do, you're returning the ball at the same angle it came to you. When you redirect the ball, you're making a swing adjustment, and that's more difficult. Also, when you hit cross court, you're generally hitting over the low part of the net. Secondly, hit inside the lines, 2 or 3 feet inside the lines. Give yourself room for error. And finally, don't be so quick to go for winners. Wait for an opportunity to hit into an open court. Move your opponent around. Winners are not always made by the player hitting the ball the hardest. And remember, you don't always have to hit a winner to win the point. Keep the ball in play and let your opponent make the errors.
Make your money work harder than ever. Call now for your Wall Street Journal guide to understanding money and investing. It focuses on financial markets so you can make informed choices. Call now to get your guide free when you subscribe to the Wall Street Journal,
where you'll find information you need to get ahead.
Get 10 weeks of the journal for just $36 and the guide to understanding money and investing free with your paid subscription. Call toll-free 800-322-5800. That's 800-322-5800.
Built a reputation for truck strength. A considerable advantage. It also comes in this handy take-home sign. Sierra from GMC Truck.
Hi, I'm Bob Gorman, and I'd like to welcome our Director of Operations, Joe DeFano. Welcome, Joe.
Thank you, Bob. Great to be here. Arlington Lexus is the most magnificent Lexus facility in America. And I'd like to invite all my previous customers from the North Shore and Chicagoland area to stop by and see me here. For the best in sales and service, come to Arlington Lexus in Palatine.
Come out and see us at Arlington Lexus in Palatine, just west of 53 on Dundee Road.
Welcome back. Martina Navratilova holding a 4-3 first set lead over Conchita Martinez.
It's not going to make Martina happy. That was a little bit of a topspin miss hit on the return. Very tough to judge. Conchita Martinez beginning to rev up her shots. She's much more alert. She's reading the ball better and hitting a bit harder.
Quickly, Martina Navratilova finds herself in a hole here. A chance for Conchita Martinez to even things up here in the first set.
On a previous service game from this end, she also got herself quickly into a love 40 situation. For a left-hander, the sun is a little bit of